My dear.
On a specified.
About.
My fellow servants of the American.
Hey, Black Washington, the weekend is finally here and time to get your life. This is DC's fave and so fine disc jockey, Thundercat. Now, I know you had a hard week working for the man, so it's time to relax, kick your feet up, and unwind. So come out and meet me later on Black Broadway on U Street. Tonight, the delightful and beautiful Miss Pearl Bailey will be performing at the Lincoln Theater, 8 o'clock sharp.
Let me tell you, it was something else. The roaring 20s indeed. When jazz and bebop hit Washington, D.C., it was like a freight train rolling through this little southern town. People just couldn't get enough of it.
Hey, Bailey, you're on it too.
Okay. And you see, this neighborhood all around U Street, this is where the black middle class lived. U Street was the intellectual, cultural and social hub of Black D.C. It was a thriving black community, created for us, by us. U Street was Harlem before Harlem. Now, that doesn't mean everything was peaches and cream. Thanks to old Jim Crow, even here in the nation's capital, black folks like us couldn't go downtown to hear music or theater. They wouldn't let us in the door. But do you think we'd be denied? No, we wouldn't. So what did we do? Black entrepreneurs started opening up black clubs all over the neighborhood. And oh, were they ever jumping? The 1920s to 1950s were the greatest musical eras in Washington, D.C.'s history. And it all happened right here, on and about U Street. Some of the greatest performers, myself included, is where we cut our entertainment chops. We had, of course, the Howard Theater, and then there was the Jungle Inn. That's actually where I got my start. Then we had the Crystal Caverns, Republic Gardens, Club Ballet, and the Lincoln Theater with its beautiful Colonnade Ballroom. And you know who used to come to the Lincoln Colonnade? Franklin Delano Roosevelt. Yeah, FDR, baby. The 32nd president of this great U.S. of A. How about that? The buzz and reputation of these establishments attracted audiences and talent from all over the globe. In addition to myself, some of the greatest performers jumped, jived, and wailed on U Street. Music icons like Ella Fitzgerald, Cab Calloway, Louis Armstrong, Billie Holiday, Jelly Roll Morton, Lionel Hampton, Sarah Vaughan, and the Duke. Duke Ellington, yeah. He grew up right over there on 13th, just two blocks down from you. What a man. Jazz royalty, honey. And speaking of the men, oh my, did they dress it up. Fellas, if you even dared to come down here and not look your best, your friends would shame you back to your house until you came dressed in your Sunday best. Top hats, tuxedos, fedoras, and zoot suits. Those men were looking sharp. And the ladies? Do you think we'd be outdone? Child, please. Our hair, our dresses, our pearls, our mink wraps, our shoes. It was like nothing you'd ever seen before in this little old neighborhood. U Street was D.C.'s Black Broadway. That's what I called it, Black Broadway. And the name stuck.
Easy Street. I'd love to live on Easy Street. Nobody works on Easy Street. Just sit around all day. Just sit and play the horses. Life is sweet for folks who live on Easy Street.